Hey. Sweet. Awesome. Fucking Grizzly Bear version X.7. Love it. I'll even do it in a higher pitch to demonstrate how much I like it. Love it. Goddamn. They should just stop with grizzly bears now. They've made the pinnacle. By far. My card's just ridiculous. Phantom Warrior, I believe, is the best war act of treason. You've got really good reason to go into red. It's funny because they're close, and I think it's just a stupid play to pick the Phantom Warrior in this instance, for example. And I do that kind of thing all the time because it's better, I'd say, than the act of treason, but just the consistency of having an amazing red card that you want to play already. Passing signals and whatnot. Gotta take this, I think, even though you can even get that back, but gotta do it. Cursed Spirit, Mark of the Vampire, Flare Sliver, some good things. Could take the Guile, that's quite good, but you'll probably get them later. Stick to red. A lot of crap, except for this. Could go on about all those cards. Take forever. Discuss their exact position. I can't wait to get out my pick order, which I am gonna do, I swear. I think I mentioned it, but I cut out every single name. I wrote down every card. So I've got a hard copy of every card, an individual piece of paper that I cut out from other pages. The second I get tape, I can do it. I had them spread out on the floor, but the the whatever size of it was longer than my room, wider than my room. Sure, I could just like, you know, curve it around and everything, but I want to have it like on a wall kind of thing, you know. Like those movies where the crazy guys plotting something. Sundial Hawk, my favorite. A lot of decent things. Things that I can't play yet. I'm gonna go into another color, I think. Quicken. I could run. The white cards are so much better than that. I've debated even between the Sundial Hawk and the Charging Griffin, which is better. I think the Griffin is. Tough to do that. Well, there's a good combo kind of card. Difficult to play, but you totally can. And it's good. It's gonna send a dream. Even just stuff with or stuff like Act of Treason. Flames of the Firebrand, that's kinda cool. Played a few of these people. Wishes just the other day. So I think I showed Saber X certainly many times. Is he a guild mage? Is it guild mage? I'm not sure. Can I be? I think so. W Cat, I believe, as well. Burp. Pardon me. I don't have to say a burp every time I do. wants the right card here, one might ask. I'm eliminating things. All the stuff on the left side. All this stuff as good as it is. Pacifism, angel, awaken, warden even possibly. This guy, but I don't like him. He's not as good as these. So I'm gonna eliminate the wood guy, woodborn. Pacifism and angel, you could argue either way. I think the angel's probably better, but it requires a big commitment to white. I don't necessarily want to play white. I'm gonna pass the white, I believe. Got really good blue. Or decent blue, sorry. Good green. But red as well. This card is that good, but in two colors it's even hard to get that many red, believe it or not. Might be the warden. Surprisingly. Take the woodborn guy. Difficult. I'm going out on a limb. It did not seem like the right pick until sort of late. It was like the last of the three options or so that I thought were good. I mean, could have taken the green guy, make use of these leaves that I've sort of been picking. I mean, leaves is really good. Of course, I want to play green, but and the white Sarah Angel is better than Warden for sure. It's interesting. No, it's like the Tusker or the Doomblade, right? Okay, good green. I've been passing it, though. Doomblade is just markedly better, so I have to take it. Ruwala, certainly the best card. Don't want to jump back into green. Definitely could, though. Play some kind of crazy three-color fix or something. Keep passing white. Pick that the color I'm ditching. Of course, I'm triggered of like white, blue, why not, or something. I'm always looking forward. Knowing what you did in the past, though, of course. The worm. God, Playcaster is quite good. The witch I don't love. It's good though. Dear Lord. Mana fixing. Like. Try to go back into red. Like the Raider. Try to go back into green. I passed a lot of good green. Including that Baeloth, but whatever. Just a lot of good stuff. Tough to say here, but I'd say the shock for sure. Got nothing but. So, that's great. They're making the green work, so it's like green's surprisingly the one color I'm happy with at the moment, and that was a gift. So I'll try to play green, blue, red, even black, maybe. Just splashing for a blue and red, black. Sort of just a green based. It's tough to play this, but you know, with color fixing, you can do it. It's like where you have like two swamps, two mountains, and three islands, or something like that, whatever. That sort of makes the mana a little bit sketchy, but you can totally pull it off. You just get the power from like removal and stuff. It's so nice when you can do that, though. Imagine if I played, I don't know how many good cards I could have with this, but. Imagine just playing like Dismiss into Dream, Doomblade, Bladecaster, you know, Shock. Like, best from all the colors, basically. And it's sort of just a byproduct of not knowing how to draft well sometimes, but it's a solid strategy, definitely, at other times. Nice. Wonderful. And perfect. Don't love this card. This is the perfect time swear. Absolutely. It's like exactly what I need. Speaking of exactly what I need, perhaps some herbal remedy. Some adventuring herb. Click. try to be a little bit heavier on the red now. Happy. Red, green, splash blue, and black. Ooh. Okay. Now, this guy's pretty good. I like this more. And those root wells have been passing. I'm going to have to do that more. Pass the pacifism. No rage is probably the best pick for me. Planar cleansing's amazing, but I'm not going to play it. Could take another sliver or something. But you can't argue with the removal that is that. Nice. That feels good to get that back. Could have taken the clone or something. I mean, tough to say. Could take it forever. Love those two jobs. Tusker, I mean, come on. Even though I'm playing three colors, I can totally make that work. Because it's green-based, mostly. I need a lot more playables, though. It's funny. I've sort of wasted a few picks. I mean, blue is not even necessarily a color I want to go into. Even black, I mean, I could just cut those two. Those are my only black cards. I don't really want to play them even. Too difficult. We'll see. I love this lower-flying thing. It's so cool. But on with better cards. I hate to say it, but Shock is better than Flying Man. Just straight up. Card for card, anyways. Pick one, pack one, you gotta do it. You gotta take Shock for that thing. So good, but not by much. That's better. You can kill a player. You gotta picture those late game, right? I talk about, but like, just all the board positions that could happen, all the many situations you're going to run into. And, like, Shock's going to do you more good than that flying thing. It's great turn one, and it's really good overall and all that stuff, but I'm telling you, Shock's going to save your ass and going to kill players more often and going to do so much more overall than that flying. If there's any doubt. Like a spell that can just instantly kill a player. You have to think about how many times a player is going to be within two. They're going to be at 2-1. Whatever. I mean, it's going to kill them. How relevant is that? Talk about just sort of circumventing the combat system just to fly over top of everything. I mean, those crazy wards or whatever, you know, killing the creature in response, getting the 2-for-1 the blocks. You're allowed to do the attacking because, you know, you just attack in this good position and then wait for him to respond. And then you respond, take something out, chucks, okay. A few things better is Flames of the Firebrand. Nice to have one of those. So, I might not even play blue or black if I'm lucky enough to get a few more playables. Seems like I am. Thankfully, I'm getting the red and green, so could maybe even cut the crazy third and fourth color altogether. Classic, just sort of committing too late almost, but oh, I should have maybe taken the enchantment. Comboed it. If I had this freaking ward so high. But I don't even want to play that enchantment. I could even play this and not play that enchantment because it's like sort of a wasted slot. Like I can use things like this instead, right? And just not even bother with the subpar card that is flying enchantment thing that I can't think of the name. But it's cool. I can play this with Lightning Talents, right? Like Act of Treason. Hunt the Week. There's not that many things, but Chandra. I could just play the Dismiss and Doomblade even. I mean, I can play this guy. I was thinking, but I only have two enchantments. Hardly worth a splash, though. I'll play this, maybe. But yeah, I guess those, I don't know, birds are great, but I think I can actually use that instead. No, just two colors. And I've got enough removal, I've got enough aggression and all that stuff. I don't need to play these. It just gets funky, right? And it sort of not as simple as you need. There's no point. You're going to have those hands where if you do run, say, an island and a mountain or whatever, you're going to have those hands where you need that island that you have in your hand to be a forest. And if it was, you could have gone off, you could have played Mystic and blah, 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 but just because there's that one land even makes a big difference. I could easily splash that if I had to. And that's more than enticing. Like, that Doomblade is beautiful, right? It's completely good. And the Blightcaster, you can play them both. Play the Verdance, you got good synergy. You play the Lay of the Land, one of searching, blah, 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 right? I know how it works, but it's not needed. If your deck is otherwise good enough, if you've got all the bases covered, you got the removal, you got a good curve and everything, you've got plenty of playables, you're not having to, like, search for other cards or whatever. If you're cutting cards, don't even bother, seriously. Overall, anyways. It's my vague theory.